But but it says this word know is different. This word here means to procreate. Okay, so he procreated with his wife in the land of Nod. So according to biblical scholars, now look, if you look in the Bible, look up all the biblical characters, especially in the Old Testament, all the way up to Jesus. What you're going to find is the Bible is the story of man's creation, his fall, and his redemption. That's why you don't see a whole bunch of stuff about Satan. And if you look at the line of Jesus, you'll see he had all these sons and all these daughters as people, and sons and daughters. But it doesn't necessarily say all the sons they had and all the daughters they had. But they always focus on the one that's going to carry the line till he gets to Jesus. Okay? And of course, Seth is an awesome name because Seth means substitute. Seth means compensation. So although the Abel was the one that was supposed to be in the line to go forward, he was killed, then God sent Seth, the substitute, to take care of it, which I think about that too in my own life. There's been times I thought something was going to work out and it didn't. And what it was God had a substitute. Something's right there waiting there. It didn't take him by surprise. He was already ready. You know, Seth was not plan B. Seth was plan A. But in our eyes, Seth is plan B. Okay? So, the same way, if you'll stop and look, here, catch. I've been throwing candy every time I ask a question. Okay, yeah. Okay, so if you look up here, Bible scholars tell us again, you see, God tells us, we're not supposed to be marrying our brothers and sisters now, but back then, all you had was Adam and Eve, and they had sons and daughters, okay? So, and nobody was there to actually ask the question, but if you just look, put all the facts together, and if Adam and Eve are the only man and woman, and they have sons and daughters, then it's, right, so but the Bible says that he had sons and daughters. Then if that's so, that he had sons and daughters, then what happened is that he was with his sister. Cain had his sister. And or it could be that he even had a cousin. Okay? It says in Genesis chapter 5, verse 4, in the days of Adam after he begotten Seth, were 800 years, and he begat sons and daughters. So he's had his sons and daughters. So more than likely, it was a sister and or a cousin. Eden must have been just south of West Virginia. I had to throw that out there. But still, that's what it's thought of, is that it was his sister or cousin, because of all the kids. I mean, there were, according to some Bible scholars, good Bible scholars, not some rinky-dink guys. I mean, the real thing. There was probably, by the time Adam died, there was probably 10,000 people just from his descendants. Think about something. You lived, he lived the days of Adam after he begotten Seth were 800 years. So it was even more. So Adam lived 930 years. So look, at Seth, he is 800 years. But right here, he lived to be 930. So it was 130. He was 130 years old by the time he had Seth. Can you imagine how many kids you could have in 130 years? Think about us. Think about our families. You know, I look at these families. We took pictures of Linda's family. You know, we got the witness protection together, and they all put us in for a while. And the picture was like, had to be 11 by 14. There were so many of them. You know, and it's just from two people, her mama and her daddy. And, wow, it's just so many people. And even in my family, you know, I look back at my daddy, and my daddy had four children. But wow, look at all the kids. And my granddaddy, he had nine kids. Can you imagine what it looked like, you know, the family reunion? It looked like the Hatfields and McCoys were going to town. And so, sister or cousin. Does that answer your question? Because none of us were there to know for sure. But you've got to look at God, know God's a faithful God, and God's got a plan. And if there's only two to start with, then it's got to be a sister, it's got to be a cousin. You know, but then as time starts going on, they start moving out, then God allows them to be like him, Shem, and Japheth. You're not asking this question. I'm just going to throw this out there. Some more science, earth science mixed with Bible. At the Tower of Babel, God confused everybody's languages. Okay, because he said, y'all getting too much. So he confounded languages. Well, what I was going to say is though, when at the ark, there was only three sons, Ham, Shem, and Japheth. And they all three went separate ways. And if you look up Ham, Shem, and Japheth, you'll see, and their wives, at the time, now it's really different in this age we live in because we're so global. But back in the day, there was only three types of humans. There was Mongoloids, which were Asians. There was Negroids, which were Africans. And then there was Caucasianoids, which were Europeans. And there's three sons, Ham, Shem, and Japheth. If you trace back their roots, they all are traced back to that time. One of them's Asian, one of them Africa, one of them Europe. And so God's got this thing together. It's just we can't all go back there and find all this. You have to put the pieces of the puzzle together backwards, you know, to build a case. All right. Answer? Good. Who wants the next question? Okay. Okay. They were just God's children. They were the original two, you know. There wasn't a nationality. That was just them, and there was no nations. It was just a garden. Again, you got as people started migrating out, I mean, as their descendants come along, they started migrating out. And as they started migrating out, each one, it's like Linda's daddy's a Wright. And they got like 25 in that. It was just him and her. And it's only been, he's 85 now. And there's like 25 or 30 descendants in that picture. Can you imagine if he lived to be 100 and something, you know, or lived to be 900. Can you imagine how many descendants you would have? And what it is, as they migrated out, that's where they began. God took their name, and when he took their name, Moab made the Moabites. Right. Right. So they became a clan, the clan. Good shot and good catch. All right. And you got a question, Vicky, or you want to come back?